Last week, it all turned a bit less wow for Wow Air. Wow Air started flying back in 2012. Their goal was to offer low-cost flights from Europe to the USA and the other way around with a stopover in Iceland. So pretty much the same as Icelandair is doing at this moment. Last year, Wow Air operated a fleet of 21 Airbus aircraft to 47 destinations, and it was the second biggest airline in Iceland. As you see here, they mainly operated flights from many American and Canadian cities like Toronto, New York and Boston, via Iceland, all the way down to European cities like Paris, Brussels and London. But in November last year, the airline announced that they were in talks with Icelandair to take over the entire Wow Air operation. By the end of November, they were forced to send half of their fleet to storage because of financial difficulties. A couple of days later, Icelandair cancelled their possible takeover plans of Wow Air, and Wow had to find another investor to keep alive. The same day, Indigo Partners announced they wanted to buy the struggling Wow Air. Due to that, Wow Air launched some major adjustments to their operations. More aircraft were grounded, staff fired and routes closed. In March 2019, Indigo Partners decided to not buy Wow Air, and not that much later, Wow Air had to cease operations. That was on the 28th of March. So, what made Wow Air go bankrupt? First of all, they were growing too fast. They should have focused on profitable routes instead of launching 47 destinations to pretty much everywhere. Secondly, they were one of the pioneer airlines to try the low-cost long-haul model. Many airlines failed to make a profit with this business model. Just take a look at Primera Air Nordic and Norwegian, which is also suffering major financial difficulties. So, what are the consequences of the Wow Air failure? First ones who were affected by the bankruptcy were the more than 1000 Wow Air employees and of course the passengers, who saw their flight cancelled out of nowhere. Lucky for the last one, many airlines launched rescue fares to get the packs to their destination. Icelandair is now the only international airline in Iceland, and the only one who offers a stopover in Iceland. They see the competition going bankrupt, what is a good case for them. But it's a bad case for Iceland. The forecast is that their GDP will drop by 3% and their currency by a staggering 13% just because of the shutdown of Wow Air. The ex-Wow Air aircraft are going back to the leasing company and will soon be introduced in other airlines' fleets. Some airlines will be very happy to see some unexpected extra capacity coming in. Certainly with the current grounding of the 737 MAX. As a plane spotter, I will miss the livery of Wow Air. Although it may not be the most beautiful livery in the airline industry, it is one of the more eye-catching liveries which flew around.